Welcome back to World Today. In a post-COVID-19 scenario, the world is waking up to a very aggressive China, realizing what it does to its neighbors, to partners, including to regions within China. Particularly of interest to America and India is Tibet. For the first time in history, the US State Department invited the head of the Tibetan government in exile, Dr. Lobsang Sangay, to the State Department building. That in itself is a shift in US policy, recognizing this government in exile. Joining me for an exclusive conversation for the first time is the newly appointed Special Coordinator for Tibetan Affairs of the Trump Administration, Assistant Secretary Robert Destro. Many thanks for joining us here on India Today, sir. Let me begin with asking you what your official position, what is the United States of America's official position on the status of Tibet?
Well, thank you for having me. Good evening. And thank you for inviting me to be on your program. Yes, we were very pleased to have Mr. Sangay come to visit with us here at the State Department. And it reflects the very serious, the way we take Tibet very, very seriously. We are in full agreement with His Holiness the Dalai Lama that there's a third way, and that we want to see the Chinese government more engaged with the CTA and with the Dalai Lama, His Holiness himself.
Secretary Destro, does the United States of America support a fully autonomous Tibet within China, or does it support a separate state of Tibet, a sovereign Tibet?
No, we have consistently taken the position that Tibet should be autonomous within China, and the our goal is to see that the Chinese respect the autonomy of the Tibetan people within China. That's the third way that we have spoken about, and that they respect not only the culture but also the language and the religion.
So there are reports, like in Xinjiang now, from Tibet, that there are labor camps with 500,000 Tibetans being forced into labor. What's your report on such labor camps in Tibet, and how is the United States of America reacting to such labor camps?
Well, we have heard exactly what you've just talked about more and more Tibetans being forced into labor camps. We are trying in the way we usually do to confirm or deny what's going on, but those are the reports. They're very disturbing. They would be very consistent with the reports and with the evidence coming out of Xinjiang that in effect, the cancer of forced labor is spreading from Xinjiang into Tibet.
So what is the kind of action that the United States of America is contemplating against China for having such labor camps and forcing Tibetans into labor?
Well, we have taken very strong positions against forced labor wherever it takes place, and we would be taking the same actions we have if we find out that goods are produced with forced labor, they can be excluded from coming into the country. We have imposed visa and other sanctions on Chinese officials. So we will be using every tool, diplomatic and other, at our disposal to make sure that we protect our own market and our own laborers from competition by forced labor.
Secretary Destro, Dr. Lobsang Sangay has always said it. I'm asking you the same question. India has always had borders with Tibet originally and not with China. Do you think the real solution to the India-China border conflict is an absolute solution to the Tibet question?
Well, that would be a little bit beyond my expertise. I believe that China and India have to work out their own problems. Obviously, both countries have an interest in that region, and you know, the United States is more than willing to work with both countries to see that gets resolved.
Fair enough. Then let me ask you about religious freedom. curtailment of religious freedom is a grave concern for the United States of America and for the international community. How is the U.S. looking at reincarnation issue, given that China is already saying that they are going to be looking at the 15th Dalai Lama when the 14th Dalai Lama is no more? So in terms of the question of reincarnation, how does the U.S. view it? Because it seems like Tibetans have a very different take on what the reincarnation is going to look like.
Well, first and foremost, we see the reincarnation issue as a matter for the Dalai Lama to decide on his own. I mean, this is an issue of religious belief for devout Tibetan Muslims, and the United States has taken a strong position in favor of religious liberty. And one of those key concerns is to allow religious organizations to choose their own leadership. So we would object to any attempt by the Chinese Communist Party to interfere in the reincarnation of the Dalai Lama.
So we've seen a lot of strong support coming from various congressmen and senators when it comes to the issue of Tibet. The Tibet bill has been passed by the House, but it is yet to be passed by the Senate. Will there be a push from your end? Will the president support it? We've seen the bills on Hong Kong and Uyghurs passed. How does it look for the Tibet bill?
Well, we here at the State Department don't take any position on pending legislation. That is a question we would have to leave to the White House. That's up to them. And we will, take any position, when we're giving clearance to do so. But right now, that's a decision for Congress to make, and we respect that separation of powers.
What has been the fallout, if any, of the Reciprocal Access to Tibet Act of 2018 that was signed by President Trump into law, despite protests from the Chinese?
Well, we take a very strong position that all people should be allowed access to Tibet, that Americans should be allowed access to Tibet. The Tibetans should be allowed to freely go back and forth. We're in favor of access, and that's what the law was all about. Well, we take a very strong position that all people should be allowed access to Tibet, that Americans should be allowed access to Tibet, the Tibetans should be allowed to freely go back and forth. We're in favor of access, and that's what the law was all about.
And before I let you go, Mr. Destro, how hopeful are you that China, even if you're seeking autonomy for Tibet, will allow that autonomy, that complete full autonomy for Tibet Autonomous Region?
Well, that's something that's part of my job, is to work on that. And I have committed to the Tibetan advocates, to the Tibetan diaspora and others, that I will be spending a lot of my time on this topic, and we can all hope and pray that this is where it ends up. That third way that His Holiness has suggested, we think, is a very good way.
And has China been forthcoming?
China can be difficult at times on such issues, but we will do our best to work closely with them to see how far we can take this.
Assistant Secretary Robert Destro, many thanks for joining us here on India Today.
Well, thank you, and thank you for having me this evening.